Hi guys, thank you for joining Artabella as we paint a grand sun. So let's go ahead and jump into what we'll be needing today. For our paints, we'll need white, yellow, green, blue, and brown. We'll also be needing a napkin, a large, medium, and small brush, and a fresh cup of clean water. So I'm going ahead and taking that medium brush in my yellow, and I'm just creating a nice sun base. Now I go over mine a couple of times just to make sure that my base is nice. And you can do that same as well, or you can go with however you put it down first. It doesn't really matter. So now I'm going in and with that same medium brush and creating some sun rays. Now you need about 9 sun rays with each one of them will have part of the bigger picture inside of them. So just make sure that there's a nice big space there for you to be able to paint in moving forward. Anybody with a word in mind can never forgive the sight of wicked snakes inside a place you thought was dignified. I don't want to live like this. What's going to make this sun grand is adding in a little bit of an Arizona themed background. So I'm creating 2 mountains as well as a nice long roadway, and then cutting that off and having my sand right there. And then I'm also putting in a second row of mountains because there's lots of them out here. So now I'm going in with my medium sized brush again and using my dark blue that I made mixing my blue and black, and I'm filling in that night sky. So I'm gonna fill in that chunk in the center of my sun, as well as I'm gonna fill in another one of my sunbeams, but leaving a space for the moon, because you want to make sure that you can see that it's the night sky and all that fun stuff. And then you can see there that I connected my sun rays. I don't recommend doing that because it was kind of hard for me to lay out where I wanted my outline later on, but it does kind of help you match up your lines for, you know, your mountains and all that fun stuff if you really wanted to do that. Now, going into our next step, I'm just filling in my sandy dirt floor kind of area. Again, filling in that middle part of my sun and then extending it through those sunbeams. And I'm just making sure that all the sunbeams in the area that would be touching are what I am painting. So for that section, it's going to be 3 of the sunbeams are going to be that same color, because it lines right up with it. And all you'll need to achieve the sand color that I'm using is a little bit of brown, a little bit of white, and a tiny, tiny bit of yellow. And that's going to kind of change the hue of the brown and make it more of that sand color that we're after. Jumping into our next step, we are going to paint our first layer of mountains. So the color that I used for this is I just used a brown with a little bit of white just to lighten it up, and I'm using my medium brush to go ahead and fill everything in. So I'm filling in those mountains as well as that sunbeam that has a little bit of mountain in there, as well as I'm filling in the sand in that sunbeam as well. So that beam does have both of those colors in there, and I'll extend that sand later on in the video, but for now it'll get filled with just that darker of the brown colors. And to wrap up our mountains, we'll be going in with our small brush in our regular brown and filling in those back mountains. Again, filling in that base sun and then filling in any extra bits that are going to be in those sun flares. Next up, I'm going to be grabbing my medium-sized brush again in a light gray color that I made using just a touch of black and a lot of white, and we're going to be creating our highway straight down the center. So I used the width of my brush for the top part, and then I did widen it for the bottom, but I thought that the width of the brush would be the right kind of size for that part of the road. Step up your game to make it to the top, so go. For this next step, I'm going to be taking my small brush in my white and filling in that moon, but I'm also going to be using the very tip of it to create a bunch of stars all over my night sky, because if anybody has seen Arizona in the middle of summer, there's stars aplenty, and we want to make sure that we have stars aplenty in our background. And now I'm going to be going in with that green that I have with that small detail brush and creating some cactuses as well as shrubbery. Now, if you don't know how to draw a cactus, it's fairly simple. You just draw a straight line about the width of your brush and then two J's, one backwards and one forward facing for the little cactus arm. And there you go. So the shrubs that I'm doing, I'm just kind of taking the tip of my brush and just running them up really quick, making them look like kind of a pokey brush, and then adding in some more cactuses. And I'm also making sure that I am using perspective, so the cactuses that are in the sunbeams closer to the bottom of the canvas, I'm making larger, versus those closer to the center of the road are going to be smaller, as well as the ones on the mountains are kind of small. Started on our background here, I'm going in with my medium brush in my straight black, and I am filling everything in. Now, in the video, I don't outline first and fill in, but I do highly recommend doing that because it helps keep things clean. I knew that I was going to be taking in my sunbeams a lot, so I wasn't too worried about it. However, if you like the shape of your sunbeams, I recommend outlining it first and then filling everything in so that you don't end up with brush strokes in your sun and have to take that in. Mentioned earlier, we do add a ring around the sun and kind of cut off those sunbeams from the base. So here I am outlining, and you can see that I struggle a little bit with it because I did fill in those sunbeams. So if you just keep it free and clear in between those spaces, it's a lot easier to outline and keep it all the width that it needs to be as well. Be sure to wonder, go in with some of our finishing touches. I'm just adding some streaks through my highway, again, making them smaller towards the center and longer towards me, or larger towards me. And then I'm also outlining all of the sunbeams, and I'll be outlining the sun as well. And that'll be it. So once you've outlined everything, you have a completed grand sun painting. Just like that, we've reached the end. So thank you very much for sticking through it with us.